Hey everybody, and happy Monday. Here's little Kiki Weegies. It has been a hell of a day. It started off this morning, I couldn't find my keys because Paul had put my keys. Where did we find them?
In the trunk
of my car. Luckily, my car was unlocked, so I was able to get my spare key, which is in the cup in there, because I had taken it out of the diaper bag, and be able to go to work, so that was a positive. And then, to make things worse, my day started out with a crabby little nurse coming into my office and being a complete biatch, for lack of a better term, because she did not have stuff done for a course she was taking, and somehow that was my fault. So yeah, it's been a ridiculous day. Hang on, please. He hurt you. So we are just getting the house picked up. I'm doing some laundry. I'm hanging with my friend Kiki Kiki's. Hi, my Kiki Kiki's. He has scratched himself terrible. I just tried to cut his nails again. But they're all short. And then he has the side of his face he's gotten over here. I don't know what he's cutting himself on. His nails are... Look at the nails, what?
When you cut his nails, you just do the one little thing on the flat on the top, or do you go around?
I cut the whole thing around.
I don't know how he's doing,
huh? I don't know how he's cutting either, or cutting himself. So I tried to trim him back even further today, but the kid's nails are already back. I don't know. He's got himself good. And then my Nady Tady, what'd you get? So tell me about these. What are these?
Raw tickets.
Raw tickets, and what did you get them for?
Good job. And I have no idea what R-O-A-R spells.
Roar. Roar.
A-O-R. I mean A-O-R.
R-O-A-R.
R-A-O-R.
No, R-O-A-R. So they get out these.
R-A-O-R.
They give out these little tickets when he's done something. Oh, there we go. When he's done something good.
And I've got two here, but I was supposed to have four. Apparently, Dad lost the other one.
Oh, it's Dad's job to keep track of them?
Yeah.
Love that personal accountability.
You're going to be dead once I punch you.
Daniel. And that's what was marked on your report card, is that you did not accept responsibility for your actions.
I did.
No, on your report card, they say the same thing we do, which is when something is your responsibility, you blame it on something at someone else.
I do not.
You just said it's Dad's fault I don't have my tickets.
But I don't in school.
Well, okay. Kegel-weegers. But we're home now, so I'm trying to let go of the day. So we are just going to have a little bit of dinner. Debating on whether or not Kegel is going to have a little bit of rice cereal. He's 4 months this week, like I said, yesterday or something. So, I don't know. We'll see. Right. So, I know. I think we should wait a little bit. Just a little couple of days. Woo! All right, so that is it. Happy Monday! Hey, everybody. Happy Tuesday. We are off of work school. It's like 5:10 at night. Feels way later than that. We are just picking up the house, doing laundry, dishes.
I'm watching TV.
Nate's watching TV.
Even though I don't have it on the
camera. Even though what?
But you're doing a video.
Even though I'm doing a video. He's watching TV. Kiki's is wiggling himself across the floor. Look at Kiki's. Pause it, please. Look at Kiki's wiggling himself across the floor, huh? Huh.
He wasn't there a minute ago.
I know, he keeps wiggling. He's a wiggling wonder.
Hey.
How was your day, Nate? Can you tell us about your day?
Hey.
No. No. Nate, you arched his back, you could hurt him. When he gets a little older, he'll be easier to pick up because he'll hold himself. Now he doesn't. Look at him. He's excited to have you pick him up, though. Can you give him kisses? He's like, brother, what are you doing to me? Brother, what are you doing? We got some PACKAGESs in the MAIL that my wonderful husband was supposed to get up long before he did so that certain people would not acquire them, but you know how husbands are.
Hey, I want some.
That's the peanut butter stuff. Are you gonna giggle? Are you gonna giggles? Yeah, don't talk to us. Brother, he wants you. Uh-oh, him spitting's up. Can you get a towel?
No.
Don't put your head in that, Keegan.
Keegan,
he just got in the eel.
Ew, he did.
Ew.
You baby pilkies.
What are you doing?
No, don't. He got in the ear, yucky. Ew. Yes, lucky, Keegan, that's yucky. Beep, 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 beep.
No.
What are you doing, Mr. Hoss? There's your brother. And don't hit him with that.
Keegan's trying to roll over. He's on his
side.
He's on his side.
How did he get way up there?
He's wiggling.
He's moving and grooving.
He's gonna roll.
I gotta pull him back though. He's getting too close.
He's alright. He's fine. He's trying.
La 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 la.
His poor little pants are too big for him.
Yeah,
pull
the pants.
Yeah.
You can stop hitting my head now.
Is that right? Hey, everybody. It is Wednesday, and Nate is chewing gum for the very first time. How is it? All right. Very good. Why are you rolling your eyes? Silly boy.
What's it taste like?
Pink strawberry, like I told you.
So today was kind of a bad day at work. It was just a lot of stuff to do. I didn't get anything done, I feel like. And to end it all, one of my coworkers is involved with a CDT here in New York State, which, you know, has to do with organ transplants. And he had a little gathering tonight that we went to, and it had to do with please shut the door. And it had to do with a baby that was born a couple years ago. The parents found out very early on that the baby had, I can't think what it's called, but it's where it's a neural tube defect where the brain doesn't completely form in the skull. So basically they're missing the top of their head. Anyhow, this family decided to try to donate the baby's organs. The baby lived for 5 days. It's just a very sad story, and I'd heard about it before because one of my direct coworkers in my department was very heavily involved with it, with orchestrating it all and everything. They ended up not being able to donate organs, but they donated or gave the baby to science, basically, so that they could try to do different things, try to find a cure for that birth defect, as well as They've done research in regards to type 1 diabetes with the baby's tissues and things like that. So what they basically did is I don't think it's just New York State. When this happened, this baby was only the second baby in the United States to ever donate its body. Since then, there's been like 56 that have tried to donate organs and things. I think is what they said tonight. But anyhow, they're having a float in the Rose Bowl parade for these babies. And they had this little girl's picture, and made out of like seeds, like they were, because it all has to be organic. It was just absolutely amazing. And the news was there. It's going to be on the news. If I can find a clip, I will try to put it down below in the description, because it really is just an amazing thing. And these poor parents, you know, have obviously gone through a lot. They have two other little girls that were both there. It was just kind of a really, really amazing, touching story, and I could not wait to get home and hold Keegan, because it's there by the grace of God, go I. But they had books, you know, like the books like you do at like Shutterfly or something like that. Because she lived for 5 days, and it's just very sad. So that was the end of my day. I could not wait to get out of work. So came home, and Keegan was laying on the floor, and I snuggled on him a little bit. He's sitting here sleeping. I'll show you. Paul's sleeping. Keegan's sleeping. Look at that sweet little baby. He keeps scratching the crap out of his head. And I've caught all of his nails. Nate, let Corky in. Let Corky in. So I don't know exactly what we're going to do tonight. I feel like doing absolutely nothing. I cannot wait until Friday. Around 4 o'clock. I can't wait. But that is the day that I had. So I think I'm just going to watch a little TV and maybe go to sleep early if I can. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Hey everybody, it is Friday. Almost 4 in the afternoon. A lot has happened in the last couple days. It's been kind of a nightmare around here. Wednesday during work, Paul had some chest pains. And it's not milk, it's eggnog, Nate.
What is that?
Eggnog.
Paul had some chest pains, and he didn't think terrible. I mean, they weren't terrible, so he came home. He hadn't even mentioned it to me, and then
stayed at work.
He stayed at work. And then right before bed, he had told me about it, and he was starting to get some more. But again, they weren't really super horrible. And it didn't, I mean, he had no other symptoms of anything, so we went to bed. And then he kind of thought maybe it was heartburn. He took Tums. And then in the night, I told him, you know, if anything happened, to wake up and tell me. And he woke me up at 3 in the morning having chest pains. He had come down to let Corky out, and he was in a lot of pain. So we called the ambulance, and he went to the hospital. When they were here, they took an EKG, and it was fine, and his blood pressure was okay. I mean, it was a little elevated, but he was scared. So blood pressure and everything was fine. We went over to the hospital, and they were kind of acting like it was heartburn, like they kind of just, because he had no other signs of anything. But when they did blood work, the enzyme in your heart, what is it?
Troponin
was elevated. It was 6 times the normal
level.
Normal level, and usually that indicates that there's heart damage. So they admitted him, and they got a cardiologist in to see him. Paul's never had any issues at all. He's way healthier than I am. He's very active. I mean, he remodels our house, as you guys all know. He walks during lunch at work, and he's Just I walked okay, he hasn't walked in a few months, but he's very active, is my point. So, what they recommended is to do a catheterization. They thought he had a blockage. So, they did that. They found no blockage. It was really kind of a bad experience, and we went to the hospital that is not my hospital, because my hospital doesn't have a cath lab. We went to the other hospital in the area, the one where Nate was in the NICU, which I really don't care for anyway. But we went there because they're supposed to be like the heart specialists or whatever of the area. Something I don't know if not a lot of people know or not, but different hospitals are good for different things. Some hospitals are like really good for cancer. They have like a really high-tech cancer center and things like that. Some hospitals are good for the heart. Some hospitals are good for like pediatrics. I mean, my hospital isn't. My hospital, not that they're not, but they just don't have the cath lab and stuff. So we went to the other hospital. So they had a cardiologist come in and see him, and the cardiologist said that because I asked him what if there wasn't a blockage, because this exact same thing happened to my mom. Exactly. She wasn't feeling good. She went to the emergency room. They said that she had the enzyme in her heart was high, and that everything else was fine, blah, 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 blah. Long story short, they ended up doing catheterization, found absolutely nothing with her either. So they did this catheterization with Paul, and the doctor came out eventually and told me that there was no blockage. And so then we really weren't told anything, and time went ahead past like hours. When the doctor had talked to me, he said that there was no blockage. I said, so what does that mean? He said, you go home. Which, you know, hi, that's not acceptable. So basically we threw a fit after, well, I threw a fit after a couple hours. Which is kind of nice that these people, it wasn't my hospital, because I was totally able to not give a crap what anyone thought and, you know, do what was best for Paul. So, what ended up happening is...
You would have anyways, if it was your hospital.
Okay, he says I would have anyways, and yeah, I probably would have. Especially when it comes to, like, a heart. I mean, that's not something we can just kind of forget about. Do you want me to get a bigger blanket for you? So we threw a fit. The cardiologist came in. The first cardiologist that talked with us, not the guy that did the cath thing, and he said basically that now they did find that there was a blockage. It was a very small blockage.
Mom.
Nate, I'm busy. Give me a few minutes, please. So they did find a blockage. It was a very small blockage, and they felt that's what the pain was from. And that's what was elevating his levels. And initially when we talked to that guy, he said if they didn't find a blockage, that it could be like an infection or something sometimes will cause that level to be high and cause damage to the heart. Because the issue is they did the echocardiogram. They did that first when he got admitted. And it showed that there was damage to his heart. There was part of his heart that wasn't beating like it should have. So all in all, I'm not super convinced on anything right now. I don't really think they know what happened. I am concerned that, I mean, he's 44. He has no risk factors. I mean, even like, did you kind of get when they asked you if you smoked, like they thought you smoked?
They kept asking me.
That's what I'm saying. Like, that's, I don't.
But everybody, and some of them asked me twice.
See, I don't, I. He has no risk factors. He's 44 years old. So if I had to say what I think because we were all sick here last week, I think that that Paul had a virus, and I think that it damaged his heart. I really, honestly, I just can't buy the fact that he has, you know, a blockage. Now they want to put him on high blood pressure medicine, which he doesn't have high blood pressure. They want to put him on a blood thinner. They want to do all this stuff based on, he's texting someone, based on things that are not really wrong with him. So, where we go from here, I don't know. He's got an appointment with our primary on Monday. The other thing is because Paul has a Stickler syndrome, this is something else, too, that they all want to dismiss so easily. But because Paul has a Stickler syndrome, which I've done a lot of research on, and I've never read anywhere that it has anything to do with your heart later in life. It can cause heart problems, like when a baby is born. Their heart cannot have, like, a murmur or something like that. Like, it can be in the way that the heart is formed, not in, like, heart attacks later on, unless there was something that had gone your whole life undetected. Okay, so because of Stickler syndrome and Paul's arthritis, he takes naproxen, and he has for, like, 10 years. He's increased it probably in the last 2 years to be, like, what do you take, 1,000 milligrams?
1,000 milligrams a day. It was 500.
And,
3 years since I've increased it.
Naproxen is an NSAID, and that's like Celebrex. And Celebrex, they pulled off the market a few years ago because of its link to heart problems. And we knew this, and that's always been a worry of mine, but the problem is Paul has such bad arthritis, it was either he takes that or he can literally barely walk. So we talked to the doctor about it at the time. It can also be very hard on your kidneys, and it's kind of a risk versus benefit type thing that you have to decide. And but whenever we talk to cardiologists about that or anyone else, they're like, no, that can't be it. But it seems way more logical to me when he's taken it for 10 years than it would be for him at 44 years old with no risk factors and zero blockage in any of the... Because I even said to them, because I got into it with the internalist, the hospitalist, when they were discharging him, because they wanted to discharge him on Plavix, but then they said just don't have him, but he shouldn't fill it. Because it is standard procedure to discharge certain medicines.
Certain cases.
Right, certain cardiac patients. Like, because they were classifying him as having a heart attack, that there was standard procedure to discharge him with Plavix. Yeah, the cardiologist said because they put no stents in, there was no point in putting him on Plavix. He didn't want him on Plavix. So the guy came in and started arguing with me, saying, this is the way we discharge, just don't fill it, because if you go to the doctors in 3 weeks, he's going to take you back off it. I said, we're not leaving here with you guys prescribing a medication that you're telling him not to take. I mean, it was the stupidest thing ever. So he finally said, because I told him, I said, tomorrow if he has a heart attack and we come in here, and they'll say, well, why weren't you taking it when it was prescribed for you? I'm not doing that. I'm not playing that game. So he says, fine, I'll just take it off. I said, okay, you do that. I don't, especially when it comes to Paul or the kids, I don't put up with it. I just don't put up with it. And so, basically he got just discharged. We have no answers really, other than that's what they say. He goes Monday to see our primary doctor, and I'm really waiting to see what he has to say because I trust him a lot. One of my coworkers did come over. The one that does the education for, like, certain nurses and things have to take, like, a dysrhythmia class at our hospital. And he teaches the ACLS, which is advanced... advanced BLS, basic life support. ACLS, advanced... Cardiac life support must be. I don't know. I can't think. He teaches ACLS and he teaches like basic dysrhythmia 1 and 2, things like that. He's very well versed in what he does. He's, you know, excellent. He basically teaches other people. So I had him come over and talk to us, and I talked to him about the medication. He recommended a couple cardiologists at my hospital that he's worked with that he recommends. So I'm going to try to see if we can get him in there. The other thing I thought about is, I don't know, the Cleveland Clinic in Ohio is like a world-renowned clinic that has amazing doctors for just about anything. It's a huge, huge, huge facility, and they have like their latest and greatest in a lot of things, and I've thought about going there. One of my coworkers, two of my coworkers have gone there for issues that they've had. It's like top-notch service, and it's the top, it's the best. So that's a possibility, depending on how this all goes. But for right now, Paul's fine. If it was a heart attack, and it was very, 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 very minor. But there is definitely a very, very small portion of his heart that is damaged. But they said it shouldn't affect anything. It shouldn't change his life in any way. So it is what it is. It was very, very scary. I was thinking, I want to say it's like the scariest I've ever been, but with Nate and everything we went through with Nate, it's just, there's times in your life where you reach a point where there's nothing you can do. When something's going on, and I've experienced this a couple times in my life, I did with Nate, probably with my mom to an extent, but I did with Paul yesterday. You reach a point where you just are at, there's nothing you can do. And whatever's going to happen is going to happen, so you just have to let go and pray that God is doing what he needs to do, and he's helping guide the people he needs to guide. There's not much you can do. I mean, whatever's going to happen is going to happen. The end result is going to be the end result. When we were in the ER and the doctor came in and talked to Paul about the high enzyme, I almost passed out. Like, I got so, it's like my air was taken from me. It was very scary. I mean, I literally had to hold on the counter because I felt very, very lightheaded, and it was scary. But he's here.
Hello.
He's alive.
Yep. Damn it.
I just raised his life insurance, so it's all good.
Huh?
So I just raised your life insurance, so it's all good.
Yeah, the week before, literally the week before.
Because with Keegan and everything, I have the ability to buy up at work. And so I did that because we have, two kids, and I actually raised both of ours. So that, if something happened to either of us, the other one would be taken care of. But hopefully that's not going to happen for a very long time. But that's it. We are home. We're going to just sit and relax. And I have a headache. It's just been a really rough couple days. Nate stayed home from school both days. Keegan did go to daycare yesterday, and I was going to take him today, but by the time we got up and stuff, and Paul, they were going to discharge Paul, so we got over there, and I didn't take him to daycare, but we're just going to relax and watch some movies and be thankful that we're all here together tonight. Have a great day. Bye.